Hello everyone, welcome to pharmacochemistry classroom. Today let us have a colorful illustration on intermolecular forces. Intermolecular forces are the attractive force existing between the molecules. So today we are going to see ion-ion interaction, dipole-dipole interaction, ion-dipole interaction and wonderful forces like London dispersion force, induced dipole interactions, ion-induced dipole interactions. So let us begin with ion-ion interaction. This ion-ion interaction is the attractive force which hold the ionic molecules together. So here sodium chloride molecules, they are held together by this ion-ion interaction and is the strongest among the all intermolecular forces. Next one we are going to see is dipole-dipole interaction. What is a polar molecule? A polar molecule is the one which has a permanent dipole. This existence of dipole is due to the difference in the electronegativity of the atoms involved. So see here in hydrogen chloride, we all know that chlorine is highly electronegative than hydrogen. Thus, it attracts the electrons of hydrogen towards it, causing a partial positive charge on hydrogen and a partial negative charge on chlorine. This is a dipole, or this is how a dipole exists in hydrogen chloride. So, when these polar molecules stay together, there will be an attractive force between the partially positive charge hydrogen of one of the molecules to the partially negative charge chloride of other molecules. So this interaction is known as hydrogen bond. So we can define hydrogen bond as a special kind of dipole-dipole interaction where hydrogen act as a bridge between two electronegative atoms and one atom is bonded with the proton or one bonded with the hydrogen by a covalent bond and other by electrostatic interaction, that is our hydrogen bond. And here we are going to see other example, that is our water. Water is also a polar molecule because we know the hydrogen of water is partially positive charged because the oxygen attract the electron of hydrogen and causing a partial positive charge on hydrogen, a partial negative charge on oxygen. So when water molecules exist together, they are bonded or they are interacted by the hydrogen bond, and this hydrogen bond is a reason for the higher boiling point of water because more energy is required to break this hydrogen bond. Next, we are going to see ion-dipole interaction. When sodium chloride, which is an ionic molecule, dissolved or placed in water, what happens is, water we know is a polar molecule. When we place sodium chloride in water, sodium chloride dissolves in it. See here, the partial negative charge of water is attracted towards the Na plus of sodium chloride and partially positive charge hydrogen is attracted towards the chloride or Cl minus of sodium chloride, and essentially there exists a tug of war, their water molecule win the match, that is the sodium chloride is separated as Cl minus and Na plus. And this Cl- is surrounded by the partial positive charged protons or partial positive charge side of water molecule. And here the Na+ is surrounded by the partial negative charged oxygens of water molecules. This gives us a homogeneous solution of sodium chloride. So this kind of interaction which exists between this ion and the dipole is known as ion-dipole interaction. Next, we are going to see van der Waals forces. Van der Waals forces are driven by induced electrical interaction between two or more atoms or molecules that are very close to each other. This is the weakest of all intermolecular forces. Consider London dispersion force. So here, look at the helium, the noble gas. The electrons in the helium atom moves around the nucleus. So here these all are helium atoms, and you can see the two electrons in the helium which is moving around the helium nucleus, and these electrons, they try to stay far from each other. So you can see they are trying to stay as far as possible. They're trying to stay far from each other, but sometimes they wind up on the same side of the atom, which cause a momentary dipole in the atom. That is, one side is partially negative charge than the other side. So when this momentary dipole approach another atom, so here we can call this momentary dipole as A and the other atom as B, and the electrons of the atom B will be attracted by the positive charge of the momentary dipole, and as a result the left side of the B is partially negative and the other side is partially positive. This generate a dipole-dipole interaction, that is momentary dipole and induced dipole interaction, which is known as London dispersion force. Next, there is another one interaction, that is dipole induced dipole interaction. This happens when a dipole approaches an atom with no dipole. So you can see here, this is an atom without any dipole, but when a dipole approaches this atom, the electrons in the atoms start responding, and they wind up on one side of the atom due to this positive charge, and the atom develop a dipole. So there happen a dipole induced dipole interaction. Next interaction is ion induced dipole interaction. This is one of the weakest weakest interaction or attraction that exists. This is due to when an ion approach an atom without any dipole, on approach of this ion, there exists an induced dipole. That is, here the positive charged ion attract the electrons to one side of the atom, which cause dipole in it. See here, partial negative charge, partial positive charge existed here, and this causes an ion induced dipole interaction. So in this video you have seen a colorful illustration on ion-ion interaction, hydrogen bond, that is dipole-dipole interaction. Next is ion-dipole interaction, and van der Waals forces like London dispersion force, induced dipole interactions, ion-induced dipole interaction. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching.